Welcome back to Read to Me TT Bedtime Series.
I hope you all are excited for another bedtime story. My name is Disha Rambajan and I'll be reading with Chandra Maraj. The story we have for you tonight is called
The Angry Son
and it's written by Jay-Z Wallace Samuel. So I really hope that you enjoy it because I know it's been a little bit challenging being home at this time, not being able to go outdoors and meet with your friends and do the activities that you're accustomed to doing. But just know that you're a superhero and it's very important that you stay at home and play your part to flatten the curve. So let's get started. It's morning again, said the son softly to himself. Gently he rubbed the sleep from his eyes.
With a jovial smile, he stretched his arms and removed his goodnight hat. Today is going to be another bright, beautiful day. Rise and shine, everyone, said the son. Slowly, he began to make his way up the horizon.
As he rose, he glanced down at his friend, the turquoise sea. What are those things floating around in my sea? Asked the sun. They don't look like fish.
Plastic, shouted the sun angrily. I hide my face in the clouds for a moment and now this is what I see.
Who could have done this? Asked the angry sun to the turquoise sea. Maybe the mighty wind blew them onto my lovely waves, replied the sea. Let us ask him, the sun replied.
Oh, mighty wind, called the angry sun. Was it you who blew all those plastic things onto the waves of our dear turquoise sea?
Oh no, not me, replied the mighty wind.
It was the humans, said the wind. The humans? Replied the angry sun.
And the sea at once said, Yes, our dear lovely sea, don't you remember so many humans came by to wash their bodies in your cool waves? There was loud music, drinking from those plastic bottles, and food in plastic containers.
They had a grand time and they left a great mess too, the mighty wind said. They don't care about us. Look at how much smoke from the factories and the exhaust from vehicles I carry away each second.
Even the smoke from their cigarettes, the now irritated wind said.
After all you do for these humans, said the mighty wind, you not only cool their bodies, you also provide a habitat for the same fishes they like to eat so much. If they continue to pollute your waters, the fishes will die.
What can we do about this problem? Asked the turquoise sea sadly to the sun. I am not going to do much, he replied. As for you, mighty wind, I want you to cease blowing for 7 days. I will command the clouds not to bring any rain for 7 days as well. The earth will become so hot that the humans will seek relief from the heat in the sea's cooling waves, said the angry sun.
Then they will understand the importance of disposing of their garbage properly, he said. The wind seized his cooling breeze immediately and the clouds agreed not to bring any rain.
What am I to do? Asked the sad sea of the sun. Nothing, he replied. Stay as you are for now, he commanded. Why is it so hot? Complained the humans on the third day. Where is the rain and the cooling breeze? They asked.
No one wanted to go to work or stay indoors. It was just too hot.
Let's go cool ourselves in the sea all day, said the humans to one another. Everyone grabbed their towels, swimwear, and tubs of more plastic bottle drinks, then headed to the beach.
Here they come, said the sun to the turquoise sea.
Everyone rushed to the sea, but they could not enter the water. There was just so much garbage. Garbage floated on the sea, garbage lined the seashore, bottles and plastic food containers, and flies. Garbage and flies, shouted a lady in the crowd of people. Look at all this garbage. How are we going to swim with so much garbage floating on the water and on the sand?
It is hot, but we've got to clean this up, the lady said. She began to pick up bottle after bottle, and then she started to sing.
Too much plastic laying on the shore. When you dispose your garbage, don't throw them on the floor.
Others joined in. They gathered heap after heap of garbage and threw them in the bins that were on the beach.
Finally, the turquoise sea and its shore were free of garbage once more. The sun was no longer angry.
So he commanded the mighty wind to blow his gentle breeze and clouds to let out a little rain. Everyone was now happy
and cool again. The end.
Thank you again for reading with us on this episode of Read to Me Bedtime Series.
It was really a pleasure reading to you. And remember this time to stay indoors, be good, Remember to wash your hands at all times. Try not to touch your face. We don't want to get those germs on your face. And wear your mask whenever you go out. We'll all be safe, and together we'll flatten this curve.